Hello, good afternoon to everyone. So I'm very pleased to welcome all of you to our new webinar today related to the interplay between tumor, microbiota and therapies. First of all, let me introduce myself. I'm Florence Fombatassi and I'm at the head of marketing and communication at OncoDesign, and I'm pleased to be the moderator today. So if you have any questions or information, please don't hesitate to ask me in the chat box on the right-hand side of the window. Before starting the webinar, just a few information regarding how it will be run. So we will have a series of polls to make it interactive and dynamic throughout the webinar, the session, to better figure out your needs and your project. And at the end of the session, there will be the Q&A session when you will be able to ask all your questions, and Sylvie Mauban will be happy to give you all the possible answers she can give you. So before stepping to the core topic of the session, let me introduce our speaker, Sylvie Mauban. So Sylvie Mauban has more than 15 years of experience in preclinical research in oncology field. She obtained a PhD in biology, medicine and health from the University of Caen in France, and then she continued her career as a postdoctoral researcher at several institutes to work on projects related to the identification of new therapeutic targets, drug development, and of validation of therapeutic tools in collaboration with industry. In 2014, Sylvie joined OncoDesign in vivo department as a study director. Since 2018, she has been mainly involved in bacteria-oriented programs for clients. So the first poll is right now, just to be able to figure out your expectation regarding this webinar. So what do you expect by attending this webinar? To have a general overview of the topic, to better know OncoDesign expertise in the field, or to obtain solid information from an expert? So you've got a few couple of seconds just to make up your mind. It will be also the opportunity, I mean, just to adapt the information that we will be able to give you in more or less detail during a session. A few more seconds to go before I'm closing the poll. Okay, here we go. I'm closing right now. So Sylvie, the floor is yours, so you can start, I mean, the presentation.
Thanks, Florence. Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining this webinar. Okay. So first, I will summarize you briefly the main discoveries that led to the use of bacteria for cancer therapy. Second, I will present you our capabilities for evaluating bacterial therapies and or the impact of your treatments on microbiota. And third, I will present you some data that we obtain in-house with bacteria or products derived from bacteria in a cancer context. The historical role of bacteria as anti-cancer agents was recognized as long as one century ago, as summarized on this picture. And at OncoDesign, we have started to work with live bacteria, genetically modified bacteria, then on microbial consortia, roughly 20, 10, and 5 years ago, respectively. Beyond the individual bacteria, an increasing interest has been placed on the study of microbiota, the interaction between the host and microbes, and the on how to take advantages from this situation for therapeutic purpose. So this is illustrated by the number of articles or special issues published on this topic, and especially over this last decade. The exact mechanism of microbiota-mediated effects are only beginning to understood, and the analysis of samples collected from cancer patients treated with anti-CTLA-4 or anti-PD-1 antibodies have revealed that some microbial taxa are enriched in a context of beneficial treatment response, as illustrated here by blue ribbons, and other microbial taxa are enriched in a non-responder to the therapy, as shown by red ribbons on this picture. So the composition of the gut microbiota may impact the efficacy of the immunotherapy by acting either as an immunosuppressive or immunostimulatory factor locally, so meaning at the gut, but also at the distance, meaning within the tumor microenvironment. And the different mechanisms involved are summarized on this figure. So based on these results, were made to harness microbiota for a diagnostic and therapeutic purpose in a cancer context. So once the relationship between the microbial imbalance and the disease has been established, the next step is to understand why some patients are responder and others not, and how to reverse this non-response. For sure, the identification of the beneficial and harmful bacteria by using omics technologies will be very helpful and will orient the strategy to be applied for shaping the microbiota and so consequently the immune response. Different approaches can be conceived for this purpose with the use of prebiotics. So it includes products that will favor the proliferation and function of beneficial bacterial species. The probiotics consists of single or mixtures of live bacterial beneficial bacterial species, the fecal material, the antibiotics that will prevent target the harmful bacteria and also the dietary components. So thanks to the beneficial properties of the bacteria and especially their immunostimulatory properties, the individual bacteria were rapidly envisioned as a therapeutic component delivery system into the tumor. These therapeutics can be antibodies, cytokines, or cytotoxic agents. And in fact, these bacteria can selectively colonize the tumor in human or rodents, where they will in fact survive and replicate, and they will reinitiate the immune system against the tumor cells, leading ultimately to a tumor regression. So the main goal of this introduction was to give you an overview of the reason why we consider now bacteria as allies for treatment of the cancer. So Florence, I think that this is time of a new poll session.
Yes, this is the second poll of the session. Just to know if you'd have any ongoing or project related to our current webinar. So yes, ongoing, yes, within the next forthcoming months, or not at all, it's just for my information. So the floor is yours. I mean, just to check the right answer. Okay, a few more seconds. Off we go. Thank you very much. So you can carry on, Sylvie, with the presentation.
Thanks, Florence. So, in fact, facing the increasing interest of the scientific community and so of our clients and partners in two bacteria as individuals or consortia, we have put in place a comprehensive platform enabling the use and evaluation of bacteria in cancer drug discovery. So at OncoDesign, we have capabilities to work with miscellaneous bacterial samples, wild type, attenuated or engineered bacteria. Also with aerobic and anaerobic bacteria, simple or complex samples. Our facilities, environment, and also our collaborations allow us to work with the preclinical and clinical samples and so to manipulate live microorganisms. Different methods and analyses can be used for culturing, detecting, identifying, and localizing the bacteria within simple or complex samples in vitro and in vivo. Different approaches can be conceived to detect and quantify the live microorganisms, the traditional culture method, or DPMA qPCR or viability qPCR. So in the first case, it allows, for example, to check the decontamination of the gut after treatment of mice with antibiotics by culturing the feces under aerobic and anaerobic culture conditions. So you can see here the absence of colony-forming units in case of treatment with antibiotics. And on the right, you can see the presence of CFU in case mice were not treated with the antibiotic. In the second case, it allows, for example, to search for all bacteria or specific bacterial species, here the Pseudomonas aeruginosa, in samples treated with a microbicidal solution. And in fact, this method is based on the property of PMA, a DNA binding dye, to enter only dead microorganisms and so to prevent the amplification of modified DNA by qPCR. Our data have shown that there is a good correlation between both methods, as shown on this picture. And in fact, you have to keep anyway in mind that when you use the first method, you will have to wait for several days to get the results instead of half a day if you use the second approach. The identity of microorganism can be checked by several methods. The most common one used is 16S RNA gene sequencing. The results presented here were obtained after engraftment of a PDX breast cancer model on mice that were then treated with a chemotherapeutic agent. Here, the docetaxel. The analysis has revealed changes in microbiota composition at the phylum level, but also at the family level, as you can see on the left and right panel, respectively. And we observed these changes in both contexts. So it means that you can see here the change in microbiota composition following the engraftment of the tumor. And here you have the summary of the changes we observe under docetaxel treatment. The bacteria can be also detected by Malditoff mass spectrometry. This will lead here to check the purity of bacterial batches during the culture process and so before the administration to the animals. The phylopeptidomics is a new principle based on full tandem mass spectrometry identification of peptides. It allows to check quickly the identity and also the quantity of any microorganism present in a complex sample. Here, the results presented were obtained after transfer of fecal material from a human donor. And you can see easily the differences in gut composition between mice that were not immunized versus mice that were immunized. Genetically modified bacteria can be detected within the body of organs by bioluminescence imaging. Here, the localization of a bacterial strain was assessed few hours or few days after administration via intratumoral or intravenous route. So the goal was to check here the selective colonization of CT26 mouse colon tumor. So for sure, depending on the information you need, these different methods and analyses can be used separately, but also in combination. In addition, several assays are also available in-house to evaluate the impact of bacteria or products derived from bacteria on tumor and immune cells in vitro and in vivo. So for the in vitro part, this includes cytotoxic assays or phenotypic assays related to cancer cells or immune cells or both. The efficacy of a bacterial treatment can be checked in vivo with monitoring of tumor burden as long as the immune response in different tissues, tumor, blood, spleen, lymph node, and gut, for example. So I hope that this presentation of the platform will give you a good overview of our technical capabilities. So now I will present you data that are representative of our activities in bacteria and microbiota field over these last 20 years. We have evaluated in these experiments either the effect of Y-type attenuated or engineered bacteria or products derived from bacteria on cancer models or the impact of treatments on gut microbiota composition in tumor-bearing mice. So as said and shown during the introduction part, the discovery of the immunostimulatory properties of bacteria has led to use them as anti-cancer agents. So as you know, BCG is used for the treatment of several cancers, including bladder and colon cancers. The colon pro-B peritoneal carcinomatosis induced in BD9 rat strain and the MBT2 bladder tumor implanted orthotopically in C3H mouse strain are appropriate models for evaluating the antitumor activity of BCG. Our survival data reveal that BCG, that is an agonist of toll-like receptor 2-4, is not or moderately active on our bladder cancer model. In contrast, it was strongly active on our disseminated colon cancer model. In the literature, the anti-tumor activity of liposaccharide, that is a major component of the outer membrane of gram-negative bacteria, was shown against a peritoneal carcinomatosis model. Our, as illustrated by survival data, the LPS isolated here from Escherichia coli was moderately active on our disseminated rat colon cancer model, PROBI. So as previously said, bacteria are good agents for delivering therapeutics. In these experiments, two syngenic tumor models were used, the B16F10 melanoma model on the left panel and the EMT6 breast tumor model on the right panel. In both cases, the intratumoral administration of the engineered bacteria led to a regression or stable disease, as revealed here by RESIST. And this effect, in fact, is dependent of bacteria tested and of the dosing, as illustrated on left and right, right panel, respectively. So here on the left panel, you can see that we have tested four different bacteria, and we obtained the best results with the bacteria 3 and 4. And no tumor growth was observed after the rechallenge of the responder mice, demonstrating that in this context, an immune memory response was established. On the right panel, you can see that we have tested different doses of the bacteria, and we observed the best effect, so meaning a good reduction in EMT6 tumor burden at the highest dose of the bacteria tested. So in all cases, the treatment with the engineered bacteria led to a tumor growth inhibition and to a prolonged survival of mice. The bacteria are also delivery vehicles for antigens. In this study case, the live attenuated Salmonella typhi vector carrying a plasmid encoding for murine vascular endothelial growth factor receptor 2 was evaluated on LC mice and on tumor bearing mice. So the vaccination with the vector used in this experiment induced a strong increase of immune response. And you can see here a significant systemic antigen specific CD8 T cell response in LC mice, and we observe similar results in mice bearing a tumor. Here, the CT26 model. And in fact, in this cancer context, we observe also a tumor growth inhibition that was partial but significant. In other experiments, we have evaluated the impact of chemotherapeutic agents listed here, and including pemetrexed, on gut microbiota composition in mice bearing lung cancer model. And you can see on the figure on the right, the treatment with the pemetrexed had no effect on the tumor burden, but at the same time that we observe an increase in potentially harmful bacteria. So these bacteria are known to be involved in inflammation processes. We have also reported a weight loss in this experiment, as shown here, you can see here. And in fact, we have noticed that this weight loss occurred at the same time that the microbiota shift. So for sure, further investigation will be needed to determine if there is a relationship between this change in microbiota composition and the response to the treatment. In this last study case, the MT6 breast tumor model was used to evaluate the anti-tumor activity of MRX0518. That is a live biotherapeutic product developed by 4D Pharma. The animals were orally and daily dosed with bacteria from 2 weeks before the subcutaneous engraftment of tumor cells and until the end of the experiment. Blood, feces, and tissues, it refers here to tumor, colon, and ileum, were collected along the experiment for further analysis, as summarized on this diagram, and the analysis are summarized here. So as shown on this figure, the MRX0518 monotherapy treatment led to a reduction of the MT6 tumor burden that is significant. And in fact, the therapeutic activity of the live biotherapeutic product was associated with an increase in immune response. And in fact, the analysis performed in tumor on the gut, and especially the ileum tissue, has shown that there was an increase in NK cells, T cells, and cytotoxic cells after the treatment with MRX0518. And in addition, an increased TLR5 expression within tumor tissue was reported. So altogether, these data have demonstrated that the ability of MRX0518 to reduce the tumor growth is mainly related to changes in innate and adaptive immune response locally, meaning at the gut site, but also in the distal tumor microenvironment. And some recent published data suggest that the live biotherapeutic product could act through flagellin, that is the TLR5 agonist. So in this context, this live biotherapeutic product alone or in combination with immune checkpoint inhibitors is a promising therapeutic approach for enhancing anti-tumor immune response. So in case you would like to have more details about this study cases, we inform that most of the data shown today were presented during congresses, as mentioned in the red box on the slide. Florence, I think
yes.
This is time for a new poll session.
Yes. So regarding, all the study cases, Sylvie demonstrated a few seconds ago, which one will be the most representative of your activity? Bacteria as therapeutic components delivery system into tumor, gut microbiota remodeling, or any others? Please check the right box to let us know. Thank you very much. Few more seconds to go. Okay, I'm closing the poll. Thank you very much. So, back to Sylvie's presentation.
Thanks, Florence. So, and now I will conclude. So, for a long time, Bacteria have been considered as enemies, but at present they are allies for the treatment of the cancer. So this explains why there is also an increasing number of companies working on this topic and developing therapeutics derived from bacteria. So even if we did a lot of progresses, the translation into clinical application still faces numerous challenges and unknowns. So before concluding, I would like to remind you that bacteria were first detected in human tumors more than 100 years ago. But the characterization of the tumor microbiome has remained challenging because of its low biomass, in contrast to that of gut. And novel technologies allow us now to characterize the bacterial load of tumors. And first results have revealed that each tumor type has a distinct microbial composition. So you can see here the results that were extracted from a recent paper published in Science. So it means that at the end, we have to consider, besides gut microbiota, also the tumor microbiota. And this tumor microbiota may affect the tumor immunity and so the response to the therapy. For sure, further investigation will be needed to understand this effect, and it may offer ultimately new options for the treatment of patients with a cancer. So it means that in the future, this is important to take into account these diverse microbiota within the body and to decipher the potential interplay between them. And anyway, it will be necessary for precision and personalized medicine against the cancer. So I thank you for your attention. I remain at your disposal to answer your questions.
Okay, so thank you very much, Sylvie. So before getting to the Q&A session, so I've got the last poll to set. So what would be the criteria that you will be choosing to come and to work with OncoDesign? Is it because we have an innovative and fit to purpose approach? Because we are a one stop shop expertise? We have to be considered as an integrated company, or because we have seasoned project managers? Okay, a few more seconds because we're getting at the end of the webinar. So thank you very much for your participation. I'm closing the poll. So before getting to the Q&A session, as I was saying, to remind you that tomorrow you will be receiving an email with a link to stream our webinar. So don't hesitate to share this webinar with your colleagues that could have interest in the microbiota. So thank you very much again, Sylvie, for this very interesting and sharp information on microbiota. So if you have any questions, please don't hesitate. I mean, Sylvie is here to live chat with you and to give you any information that you may require on your project. And if you don't feel like getting a question right now, don't hesitate to address it directly to Sylvie, or send me an email and I will pass on to Sylvie. So right now I've got one question coming up, so thank you, Sylvie. So here is a question. Do you have the capabilities to perform experiments with germ-free mice or gnotobiotic mice?
So we can house specialized isolators to maintain the specific health status of these mice. And maybe to answer the other question that will be behind this one, up to now we did not work with them at OncoDesign, but we have the capabilities to do it.
Okay, so thank you. So I've got another question. Do you have access to samples from patients responding or not to immune checkpoint inhibitor or chemotherapeutic agents?
So we have access to some clinical samples through IMODI consortium. So according to the criteria of selection, we can check if we can provide the samples of interest for your studies you would like to conduct with us. In case you would refer here to fecal material, be informed that up to now our clients supplied us the human samples.
Okay, thank you very much. So I've got a question. It's not very easy to read. Would it not be nice for the attendees to be able to introduce each other? Okay. It would have been a possibility, I mean, to introduce all the participants, but it's not the aim of the webinar as it is today. It is more a lecture that is given to the participant just to educate the people about the topic. But I mean, it is a possibility. Yeah. Okay, and I've got another question. Have you also experienced the use of bacteria, microbiota, or derived product for treatment of diseases other than cancer?
Yes, we have already used bacteria as individuals or consortia in our models of inflammatory disease, such as the colitis model. So it means that we have not only an expertise in the cancer context, but also in other non-oncology diseases.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. Thanks for your reply. I've got another question. Do you have facility to construct genetically modified bacteria?
Not the bacteria, no.
If okay, what else? If it's not bacteria, can you just explain a bit more? No.
So we can't we can work with partners or that can modify, for example, cell lines. But we have not already worked with subcontractors to modify genetically the bacteria up to now. But this is a possibility that we can consider. We did not perform it because it was not already requested, but it's something that we can study and work on if needed.
Okay, yeah. So I've got another question. Okay, so you showed an example to image live bacteria colonizing a tumor. Mm-hmm. On that technique, on what technique is it based? First question, I'm reading the whole question. And do the bacteria carry an intrinsic bioluminescence for detection or detection of do you use another tracer technology?
In fact, in this example, the bacteria were genetically modified to emit a signal that will be detected then by bioluminescence technologies.
Okay.
So some bacteria are known to be autofluorescent, and other one you need to modify them to be visible within the body or the organs.
Okay. Thank you very much for your reply. I've got another question. Can OncoDesign run experiments where tumors are infected with tumor-specific bacteria soon after implantation?
So
you
can you repeat?
Can OncoDesign run experiments where tumors are infected with tumor-specific bacteria after implantation?
So it means that we will induce the infection by using bacteria. I'm not sure to catch properly the questions.
The question. I can't tell you either. I mean, if you can rephrase.
Are we in a case we do a treatment or infection with bacteria that we administer directly within the tumor?
I can't tell you. I've got no other information. If the person,
I just want to catch well the term infection.
Yeah, for
in fact.
Sure.
Just to be sure that we are on the same page. And especially in case we speak about bacteria.
Okay. What about the person who asked the question? If you can just can be more precise on your question so we can give you the right answer, please. I presume this is Carol. I mean, Carol, can you be more precise in your question regarding infection? What do you mean exactly? So Sylvie can give you the right answer.
Anyway, our facilities allow us to work with bacteria, whatever the type of bacteria. During my presentation.
I've got just the information from Carol. She said, yes, injected into the tumor.
Yes, we can do it.
Okay, so here we go. We can do it. So it's a positive answer. So thanks a lot.
Okay, no, I just wanted to...
Yeah, to make sure that we do understand. Yeah. Okay, so I've got no other question coming up.
Okay.
So thank you very much, Sylvie, for the presentation. Thank you very much to all of you for your participation and your questions. So if you don't have any further requests, I'm going to close the webinar today. Please don't hesitate to talk about our expertise. It's just an introduction, as Sylvie said, of our capabilities and expertise. So you will be very happy to have further meetings to let us know exactly all our expertise in microbiota. Thank you very much for all of you. Stay safe and see you very very soon on our webinars coming up next week and the couple of weeks. Thank you.
Thank you.